watching this live, where we give you a guided tour of the hottest homes for sale in San Diego. And with me next is Tim Brocker.
Hi. Hello, nice to see you.
Good to see you too. How are you?
Oh, very good, thank you.
Okay, well, let's dive into Felicidad Drive.
Felicidad Drive. Yes. So this is a diamond Fallbrook.
Oh my gosh.
Right?
I need to know more.
Yeah. So what's really neat, if you take a look at the house, it was built in the early 1990s, and it looks like a very modern house, right?
Yes, absolutely.
New and fresh and all
and
that fun stuff.
The roof is so beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you. And it's a corner lot, so what I want to tell you about this is that there's no HOA and no Melrose. So even though you're in a developed community and everybody has pride of ownership, I mean, front yards are looking awesome, you're not paying an extra HOA.
No, yeah, and I know that's very important to lots of people.
Absolutely. Yeah. It affects your buying power, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Speaking of buying power, do you see the price? $550,000 for four bedrooms, three bathrooms?
That's a steal.
Yes, it
is. That is a steal. I know what you're talking about when you say
it's a diamond. We're always coming with value.
Exactly. Yeah. Let's dive into the backyard here. Wow. Yeah.
So even though these lots are what we call, like, you know, postage stamped lots, look at what we've done with the space.
Yeah, absolutely.
You have the outdoor barbecue. You got the fireplace. I mean, this is an entertainer's dream.
Delight, yes. Yeah,
absolutely.
And
absolutely.
Not a lot of maintenance, too, which I know appeals to me.
Yes, yeah.
Most
love people.
That.
Yep.
Yes. Big, spacious backyard for entertainers. Let's make our way to the kitchen.
Okay, so we mentioned that the house was built originally in 1991.
Right.
We've done all the updates, so it feels like a brand new house.
Okay, see, that is perfect for a buyer coming in here.
Absolutely. So take a look at the floors. They're tumble travertine. You got the stainless steel appliances. You got the custom cabinets. That's a walk-in pantry.
Ooh.
And this part of the house right here, it opens up to the family room, which is where you're going to spend the majority of your time.
Agreed, yeah.
Little eat-in kitchen. You know, your family's hanging out there.
Yeah, absolutely. Make a snack in the kitchen and just make your way over to the family room.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And here's a better look at the kitchen right here. Ooh, double oven.
Double ovens, big old gas burners.
Ooh, Thanksgiving. I mean, I'd love to eat here.
Yes, yeah.
Get all the food going.
This one's been on the market for almost a week, and we've been having multiple showings, great feedback. So
I'm not surprised, honestly.
Yeah, but we did throw it on a Friday. We had the open house on a Saturday, so we're gonna let it ride through the weekend.
Okay.
And we're gonna get offers.
Yeah,
we're gonna present
I wouldn't expect anything less.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah.
This house is a steal, especially at the price point.
Uh-huh.
Let's make our way into the dining area.
Okay, so through that little hole there, the doorway, that's where we just were.
Okay.
But this is the grand entry as you walk into the house. So you still have the formal living room and the formal dining room. So like, let's say you have the turkey dinner, you have the guest over.
Yeah.
This is where you're going to spend a lot of your time.
Just make your way through that archway.
Uh-huh.
Very
exactly.
open. And the ceilings, oh my gosh.
Soaring vaulted ceilings, yeah.
Ceilings are huge.
Right
Love
there,
that.
You're seeing brand new carpet. Brand new interior, or fresh interior paint.
Wow.
I was going to say brand new interior paint. Yeah. Yeah. All the light fixtures, plugs, switches, everything's updated. So
wow, you really renovated this entire house.
Yes.
Every detail of it.
And it is staged, so it's vacant. It's ready to get moved right into.
So it's moving ready.
It is.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Literally turnkey.
You might go over there later today and already see someone moved in.
Right. Yeah. No squatters.
No. Yeah. Here's a look at the family room.
Yes. So this is the other angle. Obviously, the kitchen is right there.
Mm-hmm.
And as you see, you have these like sliders that go into that backyard that we were looking at before.
Yes.
So this is, again, you know, all your guests are just right here, just enjoying themselves and having a good time.
Yeah, so you're never away from the party.
That's right.
Love that.
That's right. Yep.
Let's make our way into the living room. Wow. It's gorgeous.
Yes. Yeah. So we've staged this with a little, you know, wraparound couch to kind of show you it can be really, how do you say,
customizable, maybe?
Yeah, like to the book. Like, this is the living room, this is what you should do.
True.
But let me tell you, the owners before actually had a huge couch right here with a ginormous TV, and this is actually their TV room.
Oh,
right,
okay.
Right. Because how many people actually use the formal living room and formal dining room very often these days?
Yeah, I've wondered that myself.
Yeah, and you already saw the other area where they're going to spend the majority of their time.
Absolutely, yes.
Entertaining, but when you want to sit back and enjoy a movie, you want to have a plush couch with a big screen.
Yeah, you're
this is the
so
spot.
Right. This is the spot. And those windows, too, gorgeous.
Yeah. Yep.
Love it. All right, let's make our way upstairs. The master bedroom, huge. You have a little sitting area.
Yes, yeah. So we're upstairs here. It's vaulted ceilings, and like you said, the sitting area. What we want to call this is actually a master retreat, because you have the sitting area, you got the walk-in closet. The bathroom flows right from the bedroom. I don't know if you want to take the next picture here.
Oh, closet.
Yeah, you're navigating great. So look at the cedar right there in the walk-in closet.
Oh my gosh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it smells great. You know?
Well, that's huge. I mean, plenty of space for all your clothes, belongings.
Yeah. Let me tell you like this. If that's not enough space, you got too much stuff.
Ooh, yeah. That's a good point. That's a very good point. Let's make our way to the bathroom now.
Okay. So this bathroom, we had it down to the sticks. We gutted it. You can imagine in the 1990s, you have like the, you know, plain countertops with the old stuff.
Yeah.
So now take a look at these sinks. I mean, beautiful gorgeous. Custom cabinetry and that bathtub. I mean, anyone is going to love that bathtub.
I totally agree.
Yeah. And what you don't see in this picture, there is a stand-up shower and there's a little walk-in, you know, water closet also. So
we have both.
Checks off all the things.
Checks off everything in this bathroom.
That's right.
Great. Here's a look at another bedroom.
Yep. So we have three bedrooms up. This is bedroom number two, and the next one, three, it actually shares a Jack and Jill bathroom.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But what we didn't even highlight here is that downstairs, and don't worry, it's my fault, I forgot, there's a full bedroom and bathroom.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Right?
I love having a bathroom on the bottom
floor.
Yeah. So maybe, a bedroom.
yeah, for sure. So maybe you have guests over, maybe it's grandma, maybe it's someone that doesn't like to climb stairs. You can literally just have them live downstairs the whole time.
Yeah, on the bottom floor. That's great.
Yep.
And there's that.
That is the bottom floor.
There we go.
Yeah,
those doors.
Yeah, so double doors are, you know, indicative of a office or a den.
Okay.
But it does have a closet and you can close them. So, like, you could have somebody living in there.
Okay,
as a full-time
see, I like bedroom. That. I like that optional part about it too.
Yeah.
You know, it just
maybe
fits.
You don't need the guest bedroom. Maybe you need an office. So,
exactly.
Yeah, for sure.
That's great. I love this house. Is there anything else you'd like to tell us about it?
Well, like we said, we're expecting offers.
Right.
And we are going to hold off on accepting any of them until Sunday night at 5 p.m.
Oh my gosh, that's the deadline?
Yes, it's a deadline.
All right.
You know, when you take it away, that's when they want it more, right? So definitely get out there and see it. I can show it to you. Your real estate agent can show it to you.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to have any more open houses this weekend.
Okay.
Because quite frankly, we don't need to.
No, I mean, this is going to go fast.
Yeah,
that's
for sure.
That's a fact, for sure.
But thanks for having us out.
Yeah, of course.
Highlight our property.
This is an incredible home. Thanks for being here today.
All right, thank you.
See you next time, Tim.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Right, bye-bye.
That was Tim Barker with his house on Felicidad Drive. It is a diamond in Fallbrook. It's a corner lot. There's no HOA. It is move-in ready. Big spacious backyard for entertainers. It's updated stainless steel, travertine floors. The ceilings are huge and vaulted. There's brand new carpet. The master bedroom is more of a master retreat. You have a fully renovated bathroom, and there is a bedroom and bathroom on the bottom floor, which you can make into a study or a bedroom for any extra family members if you'd like. Tim will be holding this house as a private showing because on Sunday at 5 p.m. there's a deadline for this house. So if you'd like more information about this property, you can contact Tim with the information listed on your screen.